Run, Joseph, whom you have called from this life, give consolation to those who mourn. And may we who are still on our earthly journey always seek to please you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You
may have a
seat.
we humbly beseech your boundless and distant patriarch, your godly servant, Bishop Joseph Edra Ukpo, while in the body offered to your majesty, we are pardoned through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
Let us pray, Father, This is Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life. This is he who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are invited to his supper. May the body and blood of Christ preserve us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To receive all.
Thank you, my beloved. Archbishop, thank you. All the priests, especially priests from the Catholic Archdiocese of Calabar. Thank you, priests of the diocese, the religious brothers and sisters. Please, before we go on with some few messages that we have on our side, permit me to invite the pupils or students of St. Joseph Center for Visually Handicapped Udu for a farewell to Archbishop His Grace, Most Reverend Dr. Joseph Edra. This is the director and he walk within the average time. Thank you. this is truly a touching moment from special students of St. Joseph's Center, officially ready to Ukpo. Thank you for this farewell song to our father, our legend, and our patron, Archbishop Joseph of Edra. Thank you so very much. We appreciate this. After the mass, the body of our father will return back to Ashhouse, Calabar. While on the way, all the Christians, especially the Catholic faithful in the region of Assis, whose parishes are along the road going to Calabar, were all expected to be on the road to say very final goodbye to our father. Those who were following the most gay place, when it gets to where there is a community, they try to sow a bit.
Special companion, friend, collaborator in his grace. Temple has left many of us wondering how it is possible that two people can collaborate so well, being models of an example of friendship to the younger folks. Sister, it was examples like this that made some of us persevere in this vocation. Thank you for the devotion you have for the Archbishop. Thank you for the collaboration. Thank you for the friendship. Thank you for the good example that you both show us as we move on into this Christian and religious life. May God continue to bless you and console you and make you realize the fruits of your labor. To the Ukpo family, I want to thank you for signing to all in the land of Ukpoja. You were a family worth imitating. We thank the Archbishop for being the light, to be that great example and leaving a legacy of how a Catholic family should be. To those that God has come from this life, we continue to pray for the eternal rest. And for the rest of you who are the family who are still here with us, especially Mrs. Edra, continue to bless you and give you good health ahead of you. Thank God for the life of your first son, who was not just an example to your family, but to all of us. May the Lord continue to grant him the rest that he has so desired. To the knights of various orders in Norwegian diocese, especially those of you who are here represented, all you knights and lady knights, we thank you for thank you for all the roles you have played. For all the senior members and CMO, I know how you have been organizing yourselves from your various parishes and deaneries, and today we are here, all the women represented. Thank you, our men and women, for leading us through your life. I want to thank especially the delegates that came from all the parishes. It's been a long time. I insisted that you must come and marry our family faith. To all of you, the delegates, thank you, and as you go back to your various destinations, may the Lord give you safe trips. I want to thank all the young people. Our Archbishop was the mentor to the young people, and our youths have shown you in more ways than one how much we loved our late father. You young people, children, especially those you mentor and train in various institutions. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being always with him while he was alive and giving him joy through your presence. May God continue to bless you. I want to thank the preachers throughout these ceremonies, those who have shared the word of God with us, beginning yesterday when I came into the room in Roma, Professor Jacob Tonko, whose resounding words gave us hope that tomorrow will be better. And lastly, Father Dr. Emmanuel Ujo, whose sermon today rose us and our emotions. Father, thank you so much for the joy that you are giving us, the spiritual joy that you are giving us during these sermons. I want to thank the social media team, especially the members of our own social communication department. I want to thank you for streaming these activities on social media. I want to thank you for all the payments and all the way you have organized us so that all of those who are here and those who are absent will be able to have a view of what is happening in these few days. May the Lord continue to bless your apostolate and make you prosper. I want to thank you. Many people who have by choice, we will be around Econ by 1 o'clock. We will continue on to Uget by 2 o'clock, and we will finally leave up to Calabar around that time. So, conscious of the fact that there are people who will be by the roadside, we will give a final goodbye to our father in faith. We hope that you will cooperate as you have done to respect their wishes. To the first indigenous priest and bishop of Ogejadas, our spiritual father, our grandfather, our pathfinder, the Lord who nurtures us in faith, who baptized us, confirmed us, married us, professed us, obeyed us, the Lord who blessed schools and hospitals to lift us up, the one who required vocations in the Christian and religious life, the one who devoted his life totally to the service of God's people here in our Ogejadas diocese, we say to you at you, may the Lord grant you a perfect rest and a peaceful end. Amen.
This is to remind all of us, priests, lay faithful of Ogejadas diocese, that Catechumenate will begin on the 24th of April. The wedding will be Red Dillery, and it will span to the 6th of May. The wedding will be Ogejadas Dillery. All the ideas you'll find on the attached document released to our WhatsApp platform by the Chancellor of the Diocese, Very Reverend Father Matthew Otuchi. Please consult it and get the other details. Christmas Mass will be on Wednesday, the 5th of April 2023, the venue here, St. Benedict Cathedral, at 10 a.m. The color of course will be white. Let us come, including our parishioners, while the priests will again renew their vows to the Lord. Please, let us come and encourage them, and let all priests be in attendance. The color for the catechumenate movement will be always the color of the day that we will celebrate. Thank you so very much. And so, Archbishop, farewell. May your soul rest in perfect peace.
Amen.
Now, at this point, return the microphone to our Lord Bishop, the Bishop of Ogejadas, His Excellency, Most Reverend Donatus Edra.
We don't need to wait until 11 a.m. And we appeal to the captain and the general manager to ensure that Calabar is the remains of our father. He's not to rise. Anyway, you slow down where you're going. being available to accord this honor to my father and your father, to my predecessor. God bless you.
Oh,